Hello friends, I'm back with another DIY. This time I'm upcycling this old melamine plate of mine which we have not been using. So I have already done the primer on it. The primer coating is done with artistic gesso. I have used two coat of this. In case if you don't have gesso, it is still a little bit. In case if you don't have gesso, you can use acrylic paint or any other white color. You can use acrylic paint, you can use chalk paint, you can use multi-surface paint or whatever you have. So this plate is dried up. Now next what we are going to do is, I have this ethnic looking tissue paper which I'll be doing decoupage with. In case if you don't have this tissue paper, no need of buying. Normally we do have nowadays, we are getting fancy tissue papers in market also. In case if you don't have, you can just simply apply a coat of any color which is suitable as per your decor or wherever you are planning to keep this plate with. Then I have this printout which I had taken on A4 sheet from normal printer. So I will be using this. Then I have a golden color and this metallic wax. So in case if you don't have, there is no need of buying again. As I am saying, we are doing DIY, so we need not to buy stuff and do it. In case if you don't have, you can use normal acrylic paint. If you don't have that also, then you can use whichever color is available with you, poster color or anything, because we'll be using it just to cover these edges. Then I'll be using for pasting, I'll be using Mod Podge. But again, in case if you don't have Mod Podge, then you can use PVC glue which is available. PVC glue is, otherwise you can use this Fevicol also. The normal Fevicol which we have at home, you have to use half of this, whatever quantity. If you are taking 1 teaspoon of this, then take 1 teaspoon of water and dilute it further and then use it. So we will be starting with this. So I will just put a very fine coat of Mod Podge. Nicely you have to apply it. On the edges also. So this is done. Our plate is covered with Mod Podge. Now what we'll do is, now I'll take this napkin and take out first and then second. We only need this layer for our decoupage. See. Slowly you have to do it. I am used to of it, so that is why I pulled it up. But those who are doing it for the first time now has to do it very very carefully. Now I have placed this on top of it, and what I'll be doing it, I'll be slowly pressing it in the circular motion. Don't pull the napkin because this is a very very thin layer. You have already taken out the two layers, So this is the very thin layer. So if you pull it, then it will probably tear off. A little bit of wrinkles will be there because of the edges. Keep pressing so that it is stick properly, and then I will dry it up a bit. Just dry the edges, rest all, even if it takes time, it is okay. So now this is dried. Now this is a piece of sandpaper. The basic, very thin sandpaper. I call it my lifeline because my most of the work require this. So now what I'll do is, I'll slowly start cutting the edges. It will automatically cut. You don't have to rub it also with a very light pressure. You just have to keep it and pull. Keep it and pull. See? I'm not rubbing it. Just with a very light and no pressure at all. See. And we are almost done. Very light and no pressure at all is required. This is without season and all, we have cut it so fine. So this is our plate. Now what we'll do is, just with a very fine hand, with very light hand, just one more, just to clear off the threads. See. And we are done. So this is our base. This is still our base. Now what we'll do is, I'm using a wax, but if you don't have this, you can use, this is a chalk paint, so you can use chalk paint, you can use acrylic color, you can use poster color, you can even use fine markers or anything which you have. So now I'll just give a detailing, just to add a little shine. Those wrinkles which it already had are giving a wonderful compliment to this wax. See. Cover all the edges. Almost done. Can you see the shine around? We don't have to highlight the edges because the main focus should be our picture which we'll be fixing it now. So we should not highlight it so much so that the focus is diverted from our main subject. So this is how it is done. This is a very fast drying wax. It will dry within no time. And I'm done. So now next what I'll do is we will decide how to. So I have decided we'll keep the picture this way. So this is the picture and now we'll position it. Can you see this? So now we'll position it. Again, I'll be using the same Mod Podge gloss. Mod Podge mat. And then I'll be putting it here on this, or you can put it on this also, whatever is suitable to you. You can put it on this also. This is done and now we'll paste it here, right in the center of this, and then press it very, very gently. So now our painting is done. So now just to cover the edges, these edges which is very clean, just to cover the edges, I'm using this liquid embroidery 3D cone golden color, and I'll be just drawing the outline. Just to give a finish touch so that edges are not that clear. This final touch you have to give only once your project is completely dried off. I have used the hot air gun, so that is why I could do it in one stretch. Otherwise, please give your project sufficient time to dry up. Don't rush because you're working with paper on this. And paper, if not taken properly, if not treated properly, can tear off very badly. So I'm done with this with outlining, and I'll just dry it up a bit. And our plate is ready. Hope you liked it.